So one last thing I would like to teach you today, and it's called template inheritance. Now, we can make this quite complex, but for our purposes, we're just going to do this simple thing that'll make our templates much easier to use. If you notice on a web page, let's draw one. Most web pages have, you know, a title and a footer, and then they have some content in the middle. You know, this might be the page slash, and then you might have another page that looks identical. You know, maybe this is the slash, like, about page. It also has a title. It also has a footer. The same title and the same footer, and it has some different content. When you're generating HTML, you don't want to have to generate the, you know, write the same title and the same footer over and over again. Just like in your code, when you use functions and classes to better organize your code so you don't have to write the same piece of code over and over again, you can organize your templates in the same way. And that's what I want to talk about right now. You can use template inheritance. So you can have one template that includes the header and the footer, and then you can have a bunch of sub-templates that use that redefine the content in the middle. So here's how we're going to organize our code now. So here's what we have right now in our code. We have shoppinglist.html, and we have visbuzz.html. And these files don't have anything in common, but we want to add a little title to this page. We're going to make each of these inherit from base HTML. And we're going to make each of these inherit from base HTML, and base HTML is going to have some common HTML that these two templates will share to make them match a little better. And I'll just go ahead and show you an example of how to do this. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new file called base HTML. I'm going to go ahead and put in it things I want these files to have in common. And I'm also going to do a proper HTML document this time. I saved it as base HTML. Now remember, HTML documents start with a doc type, and then we have the HTML tag, and then we have the head, and within the head we can have the title. And so both our pages will share this title. Within HTML we have body. Now I'm going to add a new syntax here. Okay, so then we have our body, open and close, and then we close our HTML. This is the basic structure of an HTML document. And it's what goes inside body that makes the page unique. Now we could change our title too while we're at it, but let's just worry about the body. In Jinja, the syntax that we can use will look something like this. The syntax for creating a block, and a block is something that'll be shared amongst templates, you just say squiggle percent block, and then you give the block a name. In this case, we're going to call it content. And then you can say end block, and we can make each of our templates use this block of content. So let's show how we would use this base HTML in shopping list. At the top of shopping list, I'm going to say, let's add some code to our body that all of our templates are going to have in common. I'm going to add a little a header across the top. Okay, so I've just added a little title that we're going to put across the top of our page. It's just an H1, and I gave it a little extra styling. This is CSS. We gave it a background color of DDD and a foreground color of 888. This is kind of gray with slightly darker gray on top of it. I got rid of its margin, and I gave it a height of 50 pixels. Also, I'm going to add a little style to the body. This will make it lay out a little bit nicer. Margin 0. Okay, so let's go ahead and use this template in our shopping list. The syntax for this is quite simple. All we do is at the top of our file, we say extends base.html. This tells this template that we're going to be a part of base.html. Now, let's see what this does in practice. Let me make sure everything is saved. Nothing here has changed. In our main handler, we're still rendering shopping list HTML. Let's go to our front page. Okay, it's still quite a mess here. Let's reload this. Once I reload it, we can see that the header that I wrote is here with the kind of gray on gray background, but none of our content is here. Let's look at the source for this. Okay, we basically see this is our base.html file, but we're not seeing any of that content because that was in that block content and we didn't overwrite that. So let's go ahead and take a look at our templates again. This is our base.html. This is basically what we were seeing as the source in our browser, but our shopping list.html hasn't actually filled in this content yet. And let's see how we do that. All you do is here, you say block content, and this line here, block, and then the name content, matches this line here in base.html. And then we put a closing one at the bottom, end block. And we save this file, and we go back to our browser. And when I reload this page, we see all of our stuff down here now within our base HTML template. And when we view this source, we can see we have the base HTML header. Then we can see we have our form content here in the middle. And then we can have the down here, it's hard to see because of the scrolling, but the end of the base HTML template. So that's pretty handy, right? This allows us to separate the content of our pages and the templates for that content from the surrounding content that all of our other pages might have in common. And I use this a lot in this course, especially during the blog and some of the other things.